Hi, so my name is Ian. I am 21 years old. I'm from Asheville, North Carolina, and I currently am based in New York City. I moved up here last September. Just after I turned 21, I moved up when I did New York Fashion Week. I really got into sewing after watching Project Runway. I was super inspired and wanted to learn. And my mom had this old sewing machine, but she had never used it. She didn't know how to sew. So me and my dad drove down to Florida to meet my grandmother, and she taught me how to use it, how to thread the needle, how to fill out the bobbin, and just literally how to sew stitches straightforward. So what I did was I started cutting up my own clothes. I started experimenting and adding in my own aspects to it. And that after doing that for a while, I ended up with a set of clothes, which I bundled together and released as a first collection. And that was in August of 2020. After I graduated from UNC in December of 2020, I looked for jobs for half an hour before I decided it wasn't really for me. It was right in the middle of COVID and there just weren't that many opportunities. So I decided to start a business, which is my brand. It's called Ian Alexander Studio. And I started working on my second collection from there. I kind of decided to move to New York. It just made sense. It's really convenient. I love the city. I love everything about it. And then I also like New York just because I feel the fashion here is better than LA. It's a bit more higher end and focused on luxury garments. So New York felt like the place to be, and it's really working out so far. Stuff happened to me right when I moved to New York, which let me know this was the place I needed to be and that it was gonna really work out. And I was wearing this custom outfit that I made. I was gonna wear it to LA, and I was going to play basketball with a friend. So I had my backpack and a change of clothes, and I'm just walking around, and this guy comes up to me and he asks me what I'm wearing, and I'm oh, it's this custom outfit I made. And he's I wanna buy it off you. I was shocked. I didn't even know what to say. I was okay, right now? And he's yeah, I want to buy it right now. I'm a DJ, I want to wear it to this event I have. So I was if you're serious, I have a change of clothes in my backpack right now, I'll give it to you. And he's yeah, and he pulls out $2,500 in cash at the park. You know, that was one of those moments where it was yeah, I'm in the right place and doing the right thing. Because that, there's no way that would ever happen in North Carolina. And it was just one of the first things that happened to me out of the blue, moving to New York City. Kanye is probably one of the biggest, he's probably been the biggest influence on fashion since the year 2000. And that he was doing a huge listening party in Atlanta. So I'm in New York and I'm flying back to North Carolina the day that the listening party is, which is, it's in Atlanta at the Mercedes-Benz Stadium. For me, it's really important to get to him just because he's a big inspiration, but just the exposure that someone that would bring to your brand is really important, just because there are a few celebrities in particular that people really look at what they wear and care about it and want to dress like them. And it's just a big deal to try and get a piece of clothing to someone like him. So I just start tweeting at people who I know are going to be at the concerts. We end up going the whole concert. It's 3 hours, no one's came. We're freaking out because we don't know what to do. So we give him the jacket, we leave. No idea what's gonna happen now because we just given this jacket to Justin. We don't know if it's gonna end up in Kanye's hands or anything. So 2 days later, Kanye ends up posting a photo on Instagram of his locker room. And I'm looking at this photo, and in the closet, I see the jacket that we gave Justin in the closet. And then the next day, I made a TikTok. What's up, TikTok? Kanye West posted this photo to his Instagram last night of his dressing room at Mercedes-Benz Stadium. And this right here is a coat I made and gave him at the event. Pretty much just going through this story and what happened and showing the jacket and showing the jacket in Kanye's closet. And that TikTok ended up going super viral. First, I like to do a lot of textile manipulation. So I like to either do a lot of bleaching work to the fabric or screen printing the fabric before. So then the clothing ends up before it's even sewn together, the pieces just look really raw and really cool. From there, I do a lot of graphic design. It's just like a big part of who I am and helps me, like, you know, put my own personal touch on the clothes. So typically the process is like doing the textile, doing the graphics, sewing it together, and then putting on like the finishing touches at the end. And that's like zippers, buttons, etc. We really want to bring a lot of variety into it. So we're working with like different like colors and different like silhouettes. So we're doing a lot of vests, we're doing bucket hats, we're doing tote bags, and just like bringing in different things to like expand what we do and make it more well-rounded. What does success look like for me? To be honest, I'm not really sure what success looks like for me yet. I think that's something that I'm still trying to figure out. There's so many different ways that I could take this at this point. It's at a point where like the ball is like rolling and it's gonna be kind of hard to like fail.
If you liked this video, make sure to hit like, comment, and subscribe to keep up to date with all of our RealWorks YouTube videos. And don't forget to watch the films of the next generation of filmmakers.